So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session guys, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are important for each and every government exam of the government of India or any government of state, because you know PIB se questions to aate hi aate hain, jo bhi government ki most important releases hoti hain which are released through the PIB only. Alright, so let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will find the PDF of this particular session after its completion, and you can also ask any doubt here. And if you want to have a personal connect with me, you can follow me here. This is my Instagram ID. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question. Very very important question. 100% it is coming in your exam. Chahe koi bhi exam hai desh ka, usme ye question zarur aane wala hai. So the Ministry of Education, which is headed by Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan, and he is also the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Skill Development and Entrepreneurship ke bhi a minister hai, has formed a National Steering Committee for development of national curriculum frameworks. The committee will develop 4 national curriculum frameworks. Which of the following is not one of the frameworks? Inme se kaun sa wo ek framework nahi hai jo ki 4 framework develop kiye jayenge. The very important question that can come in your exam also is that who is the chairperson of this national steering committee? It's Mr. K. Kasturirangan. K. Kasturirangan is the same person who recommended the provisions of new education policy 2020. All right. So let's talk about the news. The Ministry of Education has formed a national steering committee for development of national curriculum framework, and these are the 4 curriculum frameworks that will be developed by this committee. Number 1 is for school education, then for early childhood care and education, for teacher education, and for adult education. Very very important. Do remember the name of all the 4 frameworks that will be developed by this particular steering committee. The chairman, as I told you, is Mr. K. Kasturirangan. The committee guys will discuss different aspects of school like early childhood care and education, teacher education, and adult education. Jo framework ke jo 4 frameworks hai usme स्कूल एजुकेशन का पूरा जो स्फेयर है दैट विल बी कवर्ड. द कमिटी गाइज विल ड्रॉ इनपुट्स फ्रॉम स्टेट करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क्स आल्सो. स्टेट करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क से दे विल ड्रॉ सम इनपुट्स दैट आर बीइंग रिसीव्ड ऑन द टेक प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर द नेशनल करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क्स. ऑफ कोर्स इफ यू वांट टू यू नो हमारा देश क्या है, एक यूनिटी एंड डाइवर्सिटी वाली बात होती है हमारे देश में. हमारा देश बिल्कुल एक इंटीग्रेटेड स्टेट है. ऑलराइट, सो एक इंटीग्रेटेड स्टेट के लिए, इंटीग्रेटेड नेशन के लिए ऑफकोर्स ये बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी है कि जो भी नेशनल लेवल का फ्रेमवर्क होगा उसमें स्टेट लेवल की जो टिंज है वो जरूर होने चाहिए. ओके, ऑल द नेशनल करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क्स वुड आल्सो रिफ्लेक्ट अपॉन द इम्प्लीकेशंस ऑफ सिचुएशन सच एज COVID-19 पैंडेमिक ऑन रिस्पेक्टिव एरियाज फॉर फ्यूचर. COVID-19 जैसे पैंडेमिक अगर इन फ्यूचर में दोबारा आते हैं तो उस टाइम हमें किस तरीके से क्या करना है, ऑल दीज थिंग्स विल बी टेकन इंटू अकाउंट वाइल डेवलपिंग दीज नेशनल करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क्स. The tenure of this committee guys will be 3 years, which means they have to give their recommendation within the 3 years from the date of its notification. Alright, so this was about this news guys, and now let's come back to the question. So you have to tell which of the following is not one of the frameworks. So school education is there, early childhood care and education is there, teacher education, secondary education jaisa kuch nahi hai. So option E will be the correct answer guys to this question. So I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2. Consider the following statements with respect to the Aroma mission, and you have to identify the correct statement. So first of all, the question is, why is it in news? This is in news guys because recently Dr. Jitendra Singh, who is Minister of Science and Technology, and he is also the Minister of Earth Sciences, theek hai, and he, Dr. Jitendra Singh, along with Union Minister of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, Shri Purushottam Rupala, they both have proposed integrated aroma dairy entrepreneurship program for Jammu and Kashmir to augment the income of farmers. Farmers ki income ko badhane ke liye under aroma mission there is a program that has been launched for Jammu and Kashmir, and that is known as integrated aroma dairy entrepreneurship program. Now talking about the aroma mission, so remember the objective of this particular mission is to promote the cultivation of aromatic crops. Now what are these aromatic crops, like for example lemon grass is there, theek hai, mint is there, then you know ashwagandha is there. So there are lot of aromatic plants which are being considered under this particular mission, which is known as aroma mission. And also to enable Indian farmers and the aroma industry to become global leaders in the production and export of essential aromatic plants across the world. All right, एंड द नोडल एजेंसी गाइज टू इम्प्लीमेंट दिस पर्टिकुलर मिशन इज CSIR CMAP, विच इज लोकेटेड इन लखनऊ, सेंट्रल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मेडिसिनल एंड एरोमेटिक प्लांट्स. इन लखनऊ यू विल ऑल्सो फाइंड सेंट्रल ड्रग रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट एंड ऑल्सो इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ शुगर के रिसर्च. एंड लखनऊ ऑफकोर्स इज द कैपिटल ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश. एंड रिसेंटली डेफ एक्सपो वॉज हेल्ड इन लखनऊ. एंड वेयर विल द नेक्स्ट डेफ एक्सपो हेल्ड? इट विल बी हेल्ड इन गांधीनगर, विच ऑफकोर्स इन गुजरात. So now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statements. So integrated aroma dairy entrepreneurship has been recently proposed for Tamil Nadu. So is that Tamil Nadu? No, that's Jammu and Kashmir. The nodal agency for implementing the mission is CSIR, Institute of Microbial Technology, Chandigarh. No, once again it is incorrect. This is CSIR CMAP, which is in Lucknow. And the mission is also known as Pink Revolution. No, that's known as Lavender, or you can say the purple revolution, lavender or purple revolution. So all the statements are incorrect, which means D, option D, none is correct, guys, will be the correct answer to this question. I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 3, again very very important question. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to the FDI data released by Ministry of Commerce and Industry headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal for the first 4 months of financial year 2021? So the FDI data has been released for the first 4 months of the financial year 2021, that is April, May, June and July. So is period mein FDI data kitna kahan se kya aaya wo sara detail unhone diya hai. Let's talk about the data then. So the total FDI flow in these 4 months is $27.37 billion, which is 62% higher as compared to the corresponding period of the previous financial year. And of course the reason is COVID pandemic. Last financial year mein COVID pandemic ki wajah se FDI thoda sa kam hua tha, but not zyada. But yes, ab wo wapas aa gaya hai. FDI equity inflow, that is $20.42 billion, which is 112% higher as compared to the corresponding period of previous financial year. Then talking about the top sector. So automobile sector has emerged as the top sector, jiska share kitna hai 23% of the total FDI equity inflow, which is followed by computer software and hardware sector 18% and services sector 10%. And which is the top state? That's Karnataka. Karnataka is the top recipient state with 45% share of the total FDI equity flow, followed by Maharashtra and Delhi, which are 23% and 12% respectively. And in the previous financial year, you should also remember these things. The maximum FDI came from the Singapore route. The maximum FDI came in Gujarat. The maximum FDI came in computer, software and hardware sector. This is very important to remember this. This is for the previous financial year. Computer, software and hardware सेक्टर, ओके. मैक्सिमम सिंगापुर से आया, गुजरात में आया सबसे ज्यादा, और कंप्यूटर सॉफ्टवेयर हार्डवेयर सेक्टर में सबसे ज्यादा आया. ऑलराइट, सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. टोटल एफडीआई इनफ्लो इज 62% हायर एज कंपेयर टू कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग, यस दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. टोटल एफडीआई इक्विटी इनफ्लो, सो गाइज डू रिमेंबर, यू नो डू फोकस ऑन दिस वर्ड. इफ दे आर आस्किंग अबाउट एफडीआई इक्विटी इनफ्लो, दैट इज 112% हायर. If they are asking about total FDI inflow, that is 62% higher. Okay, so this statement is also correct. Computer, software and hardware has emerged as the top sector with 23% share of the total equity, total FDI equity inflow. So this is incorrect. The top sector which has emerged as the sector which has emerged as the top sector was the automobile sector. Automobile sector. So this statement will be the correct answer, option C, because we have to identify the incorrect statement. Moving ahead to question number 4, guys, which of the following ministries has launched National Single Window System for investors and businesses? So of course, if it is for investors and businesses, the ministry might be, the ministry can be either Ministry of Commerce and Industry or the Ministry of Finance. But here the correct answer is the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Do remember this. The Ministry of Commerce and Industry has launched this National Single Window System for investors and businesses. Now what will this national single window system do? ये क्या करेगा, क्यों बनाया गया है? So it will be a guys one stop solution for all the businesses and investors, and it would bring of course transparency, accountability and responsiveness in the business ecosystem. The portal, remember, for now has been launched for 18 central department across 9 state, but later on it will be launched in all the departments across all the states. The services that can be availed through this portal is Know Your Approval, Common Registration and State Registration Form, and of course Document Repository and E-Communication. This window of course will enhance the ease of doing business in the country, and it will also give a boost to various landmark schemes like Make in India, PLI, स्टार्टअप इंडिया, स्टैंड अप इंडिया एंड एटसेट्रा. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस न्यूज एंड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री हेडेड बाय मिस्टर पीयूष गोयल इज द करेक्ट आंसर. ही इज ऑल्सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ कंज्यूमर अफेयर्स, फूड एंड पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड ही इज ऑल्सो द लीडर इन राज्यसभा नाउ. ही इज ऑल्सो द लीडर इन राज्यसभा बिकॉज थावरचंद गहलोत इज नाउ द गवर्नर ऑफ कर्नाटक. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. With which foundation Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying, which of course comes under the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, which is headed by Purushottam Rupala, has signed an MOU to work together on improving India's livestock sector to support the nation's food and nutritional security? Very direct question, one marker question, and it can be asked in your exam. The correct answer, guys, to this question is Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, with which the Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying has signed this MOU. And this MOU, guys, has been signed to work together on improving India's livestock sector to support the nation's food and nutritional security. Of course, ye to question mein mention tha. Now, what will this foundation do? How this foundation will provide its support? So, this foundation, guys, will provide technical assistance for the design and delivery of new technologies in the sector of animal husbandry and dairying, thereby supporting the India's food and nutritional security. So, the correct answer to should be Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Option E will be the correct answer. So guys, that's it for the session and I hope all the questions are clear. And guys, some students are asking कि भाई session daily होना चाहिए क्योंकि कुछ news छूट जा रही है. So देखो, आपको इस चीज़ की चिंता करने की कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है कि कौन सी news छूट रही है और कौन सी news नहीं छूट रही है. It is on me. NABARD के exam में, उससे पहले RBI के exam में ये चीज़ें prove हो चुकी हैं कि जो session हम यहाँ पे cover करते हैं, जो news इसमें cover की जाती हैं, these are more than enough. ठीक है, तो आपको ये चिंता करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. देखो, PIB में एक दिन में भर के न्यूज आती है, बट ऑल दोज न्यूज आर नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम. सो इररिलेवेंट चीजें करने का कोई मतलब नहीं है. सो मेरा हमेशा ये टारगेट रहता है कि केवल वही चीजें उठाई जाएं जो कि रिलेवेंट है. ओके, और अगर कभी ऐसा मुझे लगेगा कि हाँ कुछ न्यूज कम पड़ रही, कुछ न्यूज जो है वो छूट जा रही है ऑल्टरनेट सेशंस की वजह से, तो आई विल डू इट रेगुलरली. उसकी कोई अगर जरूरत पड़ेगी तो मैं डेफिनेटली कर दूंगा. मेरा जो पॉइंट है वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ ये है कि पूरा का पूरा PIB कवर हो आपके सामने, और वो कवर हो रहा है, तो उसके लिए आपको चिंता करने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग गाइस. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.